robots, a smart box, and a coordinated effort that could one day save lives in the field. This was the idea behind a recent NOC-AD demonstration at Webster Outlying Field in St. Inigo's, Maryland. It's called CURI, short for Cooperative Unmanned Air Systems and Robots for Remote Explosive Ordnance Disposal.
And essentially the problem we're trying to solve is today, if there's a suspected improvised explosive device or IED, the warfighter has to potentially transit a war zone where they could be subject to hostile actions.
Visitors saw a robot emerge from a smart crate on its own. Crews several miles north at Patuxent River Naval Air Station observed the whole thing through a camera on the robot with the help of a communications link attached to an unmanned Tiger Shark aircraft. The aircraft, operated by crews from the University of Maryland. Once the robot is out of the box, the operators can move the robot from where they sit. After the mission is over, the robot moves back into the box on its own. The technology and the years of teamwork behind the operation started with a robotics technologist.
During the Middle East conflicts, the EOD technician was exposed to all kinds of hazards, trying to eliminate hazard. And so that's where I had this idea from. You know, what can I do to make my technicians safer, keep them out of harm's way, and allow them to also carry out their mission?
From that, the idea came to have a robot do the dirty work for the service members in the field. These robots can be operated from miles away. Enter the folks from the robotics lab in Lakehurst, New Jersey.
We had to be able to, without any sort of user intervention, have the robot find the crate, drive to the front of the crate, open the crate up, and then drive into the container, and then close everything up for retrieval.
We essentially programmed all of the mechanisms or high-level behaviors that would tell the robot how to do its job of entering and exiting the container.
So on this day, the CURI demonstration proved wildly successful, illustrating two major accomplishments for the teams.
The autonomy that's required to provide the smarts to that robot, to drive up into that robot, is not trivial by any means. So we've reduced risk for a fully autonomous deployed robot by leaps and bounds today. Second is to provide real-time communication to a robot over 10 miles is also a very, very big deal.
So we're essentially demonstrating a technology that we hope in the future will become something that the fleet will use. We were able to do it today, that we were able to demonstrate it, and hopefully more projects come out of this. You know, it opens the door to doing more testing with technology like what we demonstrated today.
The next steps? Making the smart box and its robots sturdier to handle all kinds of tough weather and environmental challenges. The CURI demonstration is part of a larger series of test exercises known as ANTX TestX.